What's happening, guys? Keith here with your September 16th edition of the Impact Report. So if you haven't checked out my review of this past week's episode of Impact, you can do so by clicking the link at the top of the screen. And speaking of this past week's episode of Impact, it drew 258,000 viewers and ranked 145 on Cable's Top 150. This is up from last week's 236,000 viewers, and the numbers have been increasing every week since early August. So heading over to the YouTube, we check out the top three viewed videos from this past week's episode of Impact. Number three, Austin Aries, Moose, and Killer Cross destroy KM and Falaba. This had 61,000 views. Number two, Austin Aries grants a world title shot to Falaba, 66,000 views. And number one, Congo Kong versus Brian Cage with 75,000 views. Impact usually has one video that does over 100,000 views, but this week it seemed like everyone was kind of grouped together. There's a handful of other ones in the upper 50,000 range, so we learned this past week that Impact Wrestling has announced Comda.com as presenting sponsor for Bound for Glory. Here's some information from the press release. It says, Impact Wrestling announced today it has signed an agreement with Comda Advertising Connections to serve as the presenting sponsor for the annual pay-per-view extravaganza Bound for Glory, which takes place on October 14th in New York City, New York. The sponsorship agreement includes event branding, production of custom content, and product integration. Fans will also have the opportunity to receive free prizes and giveaways and to be included in a lottery for ringside seats for Impact Wrestling's television tapings in Las Vegas, Nevada, which take place from November 11th through the 13th, 2018. We are delighted to partner with Comda Advertising Connections for one of our biggest events of the year, said Ed Norholm, president of Impact Wrestling. This collaboration for exclusive Impact Wrestling merchandise and prizing provides great incentive for our fans to follow us across all platforms. Comda is an established brand whose history is one of innovation and commitment to customer service, so they are a great partner to work with on developing new products and marketing campaigns to engage our diverse audience. Comda is extremely excited for the opportunity to be presenting sponsor of Bound for Glory, said Comda President Michael Warren. We are very impressed with the level of talent at Impact Wrestling and particularly enthusiastic about the lineup at Bound for Glory. We see this as a unique situation where we can help promote a fantastic event and at the same time bring awareness to a broad audience of what Comda can do for businesses of all sizes. So this is great news for Impact Wrestling. I was hoping they would go this route and be able to grab a sponsor. So great news there. The Gorilla Position posted a fantastic article titled Steven's Impact. When 7-year-old Steven Spice stopped in to visit with Impact Wrestling roster, it had a profound effect on his life. But it was his courage that had an effect on the lives of those around him. Steven was born with a rare condition known as Chiari malformation. During one of his countless times spent in recovery, Steven discovered professional wrestling and quickly became a loyal fan. It gave him an outlet, even when he couldn't do the same aggressive things as his heroes were doing. As his passion grew, his family looked for a new way that he could safely get a closer look at the action. They initially reached out to the Make-A-Wish Foundation, but were turned down. Steven's condition wasn't considered terminal by their standards. Undaunted, they contacted Impact Wrestling's executive Scott Damore through a mutual friend, Aaron Weiss, who shared Steven's story. It worked, and Damore put the family in touch with the company's media director, Ross Foreman, who took things from there. After having yet another surgery on June 19th, Steven would have the opportunity to attend an Impact event just 2 months later, provided he was going to be strong enough to make it to the show. And while he was there, Foreman had arranged for him to accompany one of Impact's stars to the ring. This is a fantastic article, very heartwarming. I will post a link in the comment section below so you guys can check it out. But a great thing what Impact Wrestling did here. We also learned on this past week's episode of Impact that there would be a Hall of Fame induction during the Bound for Glory weekend. We will find out who is inducted on this week's episode of Impact. ProWrestling.com posted an article titled 13 Names That Need to Be Included in the Impact Pro Wrestling Hall of Fame. I'm just going to give you guys the 13 names that were mentioned, and then I'll throw a link in the comment section so you guys can actually check out the article. So the names were Chris Sabin, Christopher Daniels, Austin Aries, Ken Shamrock, Mike Tenay, James Storm, The Beautiful People, Madison Rain, Velvet Sky, and Angelina Love, Jerry Lynn, Low-Key, Abyss, and Awesome Kong. This week's guest on the Impact Wrestling Media Conference was Scarlett Bordeaux, but before we get to her, Josh came on, and he said that the format for the teleconference is going to change next week. It'll be more fan interactive and, I guess, more fun. That's how he put it. He was asked about if there is any concern with how the ratings have been. He said concerned isn't the word, but they are definitely aware. They understand that there is competition on Thursday nights with football, and that people are using all different platforms to watch nowadays. He was asked about the angle between himself and Matt Sydal, with him as the spiritual guide, which he first kind of wrote off and said, I have no idea what you're talking about. But then he went on to say that the angle was basically axed because of the departure of Jeremy Borash, so the commentary team plans had changed, and he's still happy behind the desk. This is when Scarlett came on, and she said the company is completely different from when she joined the company for Knockouts Knockdown years back. She's asked who she wants to get in the ring with in Impact Wrestling, and she says Tessa because she is at the top, but then praises the entire Knockouts division and says she is looking forward to wrestling all of them. She's asked about wrestling in Mexico and Japan, working with AAA and Stardom, and what she's learned from those experiences. She said they are two very different places, especially the fans. She says in Mexico, there's a lot of improv in the ring, and it's very challenging because many of the girls she worked with didn't speak much English. She also talked about working in India as well and hoping to work in the UK and Australia in the future. She asked what got her into wrestling, and she said that she actually worked with girls who went to indie wrestling shows, and she didn't know much about it, so she ended up going with them, and that kind of got her hooked. And she said she actually missed her prom to go to a wrestling show. She says she is very happy with Impact, and she loves what she's doing, being able to travel and perform all over the world. She says that Don Callis was actually the one to come up with the phrase, I will not be hot shamed. She was asked about her biggest obstacles, and she says, being new to wrestling and not knowing a lot because she didn't grow up a wrestling fan. She basically said that her character is a parody of the women's revolution in wrestling. She says wrestling is an art form, and she is having fun with it. She's asked about who she wants on the Smoke Show in the future. She says that she'd love Austin Aries, Moose, and Killer Cross, along with other Knockouts. She says her character, people either love or hate it. She says that people on social media get upset with her because they want the attention. She's asked if she would like to see intergender wrestling in Impact Wrestling after we saw her give Trevor Lee a Canadian Destroyer, and she says, sure, why not? She's asked what advice she would give from her journey, and she says, just do what makes you happy and follow your heart. She was asked about wrestling in India, and she says she wrestled for the Great Khali's Wrestling Company. They wrestled in front of 70,000 one night and 50,000 the next. It is one of her favorite trips, and that was pretty much all for her on the teleconference. I mean, there were some other things here and there that were mentioned, but didn't really seem necessary. But that's pretty much it. I did happen to catch the Night of the Dummies One Night Only with Eli Drake as the focal point. And if you guys haven't checked that out, I would definitely recommend checking it out. Eli was the spotlight of the entire show, and we haven't really seen that in quite some time. So it was a great change. The main event with him and Eddie Edwards was fantastic. Just so much fun. The crowd was super into it, very fan interactive, and like I said, it was just a lot of fun. And then last weekend we had Impact Wrestling versus the UK, which was another great show, minus a lot of people complaining about the ads that kept popping up on the Twitch stream, which I get. I had that same problem, but I understand. But yeah, some great matches there. I enjoyed the Knockouts match. The tag team title match between LAX and Storm and Fleisch was a fantastic matchup. And the barbed wire bat death match with Jimmy Havoc versus Sammy Callahan, great match too. So if you guys haven't checked out those shows, I definitely recommend checking them out. But yeah, that's pretty much all I have for today. I will see you guys back on Friday for another Impact review. Thanks for checking out my video, and until next time, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks, guys. Bye.